Hello friends, let's go through chemistry's new chapter. It is called chapter number 3, metals and non-metals. According to our study for metals and non-metals, first we start with the common properties of metal and non-metal. First we start with common properties of metals. They are, metal possesses shining on their surface, we call simply is luster, when they are in pure form. There will be metals are solid and hard. Properties of metals will be malleability and ductility. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Metals possesses high melting points and boiling points. Metals are sonorous. While in comparison of non-metals, non-metals simply generally exits their solid or gases at room temperature. Exception, bromine is liquid in the form of room temperature. As same as metals, at comparison as metals, non-metals are non-conductors of heat and electricity. Non-metals or non-metallic elements do not possess malleability and ductility. As compared to metals, non-metals have lower melting and boiling points. Their non-metals are non-sonorous. Let's see quickly because the points are important for the study of all chapter, metal and non-metals. Common properties of metals. Metals possess shining on their surface while they will be in their pure form. They will be solid and hard in generally. The properties of metals are, they possess malleability and ductility. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Metal possess high melting points and boiling points, and metals are sonorous. While in case of non-metals generally exist in their solid or gases at the room temperature, while bromine, it will be liquid at room temperature, exception bromine. Non-metals are non-conductors of heat and electricity, and non-metals do not possess malleability and ductility. At comparison of metals, non-metals have lower melting and boiling points and they will be non-sonorous. Here we discuss about general properties of metal and non-metals. But metals and non-metals can be possessed in large number, can be exist in large number. So some metals and non-metals cannot show this type of properties. So we take exceptions of metallic elements. As we see, the metallic elements can be exist generally solid and hard form at room temperature. But in the case of mercury say in the liquid form at room temperature. As we see, the property of metal says us that the metals conduct good conductors of heat and electricity and high melting points and boiling points, while calcium and cesium shows low melting points. As we see, the metals will be solid and hard in their form, but alkali metals like lithium, sodium and potassium are very soft. We cut them with knife, while another metals do not cut easily. See exceptions of non-metallic elements. First we see, generally the non-metals are, there exist solid or gases at room temperature, but exception bromine, it will be liquid at room temperature. As we see, the non-metals do not luster in their form, but iodine non-metal shows luster in their form. As we see here, the non-metallic element shows lower melting and boiling point, but in case of diamond and allotrope of carbon, it shows high melting point. As we study already about carbon in chapter number 4, so we know the structure of carbon is long chain structure, so it shows high melting point. As we see, the non-metallic elements have non-conductors of heat and electricity, but in case of graphite and allotrope of carbon, it conducts electric current, it possesses electric current, it conducts electric current. When the question arises in which form, you give the answer. Common properties of metals, common properties of non-metals, exceptions of metallic elements, exceptions of non-metallic elements. Before write the four questions answer, you can read the activity. Number 3.1 to 3.7. Don't write it, don't want to write it, but read properly. Activity number 3.1 to 3.7. After activity, these points can be proved for the common properties of metals, common properties of non-metals, exceptions of metallic elements, exceptions of non-metallic elements. Let's go through the activity number 3.8. See in the textbook what the activity says us that. You can open your textbook, page number 40. Activity 3.8, which will be present in page number 40. Activity says us that take a magnesium ribbon and some sulfur powder, burn the magnesium ribbon, collect the ashes formed and dissolve them in water. Then test the resultant solution with both red and blue litmus paper. Is the product formed on burning magnesium, acidic or basic? Now burn sulfur powder. Place a test tube over the burning sulfur to collect the fumes produced and some water to the above test tube and shake. Test this solution with blue or red litmus paper. Is the product formed on burning sulfur, acidic or basic? Can you write equations for this reactions? You cannot write the whole activity, but you can take, you can write the answers for this. The answers will be asking in board exam. In board exam, they will be important. Board exam is differ from the school exam. So you have to study all the things which will be given in the textbook. So let's see. First, take a magnesium ribbon. First, we take the ribbon, magnesium ribbon study, and then we write about the sulfur. Burn magnesium ribbon, collect the ashes and form dissolved water. We already study in chapter number 1 in first topic, when magnesium ribbon can be burned in the air, it will be so magnesium oxide. When we take the ash, collect the ashes, form and dissolve them in water and test with the red or blue litmus paper. As we see, the magnesium oxide will be basic in nature. So when we taste it, it converts red litmus paper to blue litmus paper. Red litmus paper to blue litmus paper because they are acidic in nature as per our chapter number 2. So when we write the equations for this, we already know the equations for this and the equations are so easy. Magnesium burn in air, so here we write the physical properties. Magnesium solid burn in air, so it shows oxygen, it will be magnesium oxide. To balance the equation, here two molecules of oxygen, here one, so we put two. Imbalance in magnesium, so we put two. Here the equation will be balanced. When magnesium oxide, see in activity we put a water in the dissolved water in the ashes, so magnesium oxide react with water forms magnesium hydroxide. They will be in aqueous form. While in another case, while in case of sulfur, see what we do. Burn sulfur powder, place a test tube over the burning sulfur to collect the fumes produced because the gas of sulfur dioxide will be taken in the test tube. When we burn sulfur powder, when gas can be formed, we they we put test tube inverted in the to collect the gas, and with when which test tube we collect the gas, we dissolve water in it and test it with the litmus paper. What will we see? See, when sulfur powder can be burned in the air, it shows the gas sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide will be acidic in their nature, so it shows blue litmus paper. It turns blue litmus paper to red litmus paper. Let's see the equations for this. Equations for the burning of sulfur powder. First we write the sulfur in solid form burn in air, it shows the gas sulfur dioxide. When sulfur dioxide can combine with can dissolve in water, it shows sulfurous acid. It will be shows H2SO3 sulfurous acid. Question will be arise in board exam, so you can write the answers for both. Magnesium ribbon can be burned in air, shows magnesium dioxide. When magnesium dioxide can dissolve in water, it turns red litmus paper to blue litmus paper. So it will be in basic in their nature according to chapter number 2. The equations for this activity is 2 Mg plus O2 gives us 2 MgO. MgO with reacts with water forms MgOH twice. Magnesium hydroxide. When sulfur powder is burned in air, it forms the gas sulfur dioxide, which will be acidic in their nature, and it turns blue litmus paper to red litmus paper according to chapter number 2. The equations for sulfur powder are S plus O2 gives us SO2, and SO2 reacts with sulfur dioxide, reacts with water, it forms H2SO3 sulfurous acid. So the question arises in the form of equations or in the form of explanation. You can study whole the activity, you can read whole the activity and then write the answer for this activity. First you have to read the activity number 3.1 to 3.7 and then write the answers of 4 questions: common properties of metals, common properties of non-metals, exceptions of metallic element, exceptions of non-metallic elements, and then write the answer of activity number 3.8.